Only minutes after the opening bell and another sharp drop in stocks on Wall Street, caused mostly by worries that these are opening salvos of a trade war between the U.S. and China. On Wednesday, China announced tariffs of up to 25% on U.S. goods, ranging from soybeans, cars, and chemicals. It was in retaliation for President Donald Trump's proposal of tariffs on China. Considering total trade between the U.S. and China is $650 billion, $100 billion in tariffs may not constitute a trade war, just yet. On Wednesday, Larry Kudlow, Trump's newly installed director of the National Economic Council, tried to calm the markets.
I mean, I would take the president seriously on this tariff issue. There are carrots and sticks in life. But he is ultimately a free trader. He said that to me. He said it publicly. So he wants to solve this with the least amount of pain.
President Trump may be trying to drive a hard bargain, but China appears to see this in starker terms.
This is not the smoke before the fire. This is the real fire, the real trade war. The war is ongoing. You don't necessarily need to impose the tariff or ban imports to start a trade war.
Trump's proposed tariffs against China are just that, a proposal. They're still subject to public comment. There will likely be hearings on them. But if it goes through, the tariffs could take effect as early as mid-May. And it will hit middle America. Farmers for Free Trade released this ad imploring Trump for help. Soybeans imported from the U.S. are targeted for tariffs and could cripple farmers.
We're very optimistic about the economy under President Trump. However, we're very concerned about the trade policies from Washington. We depend on free trade policies to maintain our export markets.
On Wall Street, by closing bell, the markets had recovered, at least for a day. Everyone knowing, however, this tariff fight could not only damage the U.S. and China, but have repercussions around the world. Gabriel Elizondo, Al Jazeera, New York.